Hi guys, let me try and explain the issue with capitalism as Marx saw it, by way of using some very simple mathematical equation that anyone will be able to understand. We start with the day in the life of an employed person. It can be divided into two parts. One is V and the other is S. V stands for the value of variable capital. Value of variable capital. What it means is that suppose if you start off say at 9 a.m. in the morning, then by 2 p.m. you have justified your wages, your salary that you are getting. Anything extra that you are putting in is essentially contributing towards surplus. This is the value of surplus. This is the source of profit as we know. Now, this being the average day of a employed person across the globe, there are, I don't know, 2.5-3 billion people who are employed currently, and so therefore the summation of the value would essentially be multiplied by that many number of people who are currently employed. Now, according to Marx, S by V is essentially what he calls the rate of surplus value. But what we are more interested in is his issue with profit. And to derive the equation on the profit is very simple. It's essentially the surplus that you are creating divided by C plus V. We already know what S and V stand for. C, according to Marx, is the constant capital. Plants and machineries, essentially, that is needed along with the human labor to kind of produce the output. This is a constant because its value does not increase according to Marx. I mean, if you buy a machine, I mean, it does not have the capability to increase its value. So it's a constant. So this equation essentially is where Marx says there's an issue with capitalism. How? Suppose if we were to do a simple mathematical exercise and divide this equation with V. So the new equation then becomes S by V. Okay. Or this is equal to S by V by C by V plus 1. According to Marx, and the crux of his issue with capitalism is that this value has a tendency of diminishing over a period of time. Why is that? It's because to be competitive, to stay in fact, to have any kind of competitive advantage over competition in a capitalistic setup, the owner cannot fritter away this entire surplus by way of purchasing luxurious goods for himself and then going on vacations and stuff like that. He has to plow back a certain amount of money into his setup. So this value of C essentially goes up. And with more technology coming into the picture, with the advances in the Industrial Revolution, the value of V essentially is going down, whereas the value of C, which is your constant capital, is going up. So in any processing industry today, if you go, you'll have less labor and more machineries, and work is being done by a press of a button, and that's essentially where the issue is. So this denominator, essentially the value goes up, whereas the if the numerator value, which is S by with the rate of surplus, is lower than the denominator, then this entire equation essentially starts diminishing. And that's where the issue with capitalism is, and you cannot help it because industrialist will have to invest behind this S, behind creating more surplus, to find ways of creating more surplus, to take money out of this surplus and invest behind his constant capital. All that we can do, but then this the other point is that this essentially is a value, and it's a value and not exactly a monetary representation of the same. The monetary representation of the same can be very different from this particular value. For example, what happened in the 2008-9 crisis in the US, where this was all masked under credit, huge amount of credits in the economy, and the monetary representation of this crisis was very different from this particular value that this equation was throwing up. So the question, therefore, and this to reiterate, is according to Marx the issue with capitalism. Now the question is, what next? Is there no way of jumping out of this crisis? Yes, there are. If you can kind of reduce this value of C, there is a way. Or if you can reduce the value of or increase the value of S, for that matter, or reduce the value of V, I think then that's the way in which companies can kind of jump out of this crisis. Now, how do you do that? And I think that brings us to what we are seeing is happening at this point of time, post-capitalism, which is essentially companies coming together, large conglomerates forming, which are essentially reducing the value of your constant capital, your assets, so to say. You're kind of outsourcing everything. There is no physical asset, so to speak. When that is happening, it's also creating a lot of pressure on employment. Employment is going down. There are a lot of, with so many companies becoming bust, there is surplus labor out there in the market, and they're willing to work for lower wages. So this value of V kind of comes down. There's another way of increasing S by increasing your working hours. You know, for example, what has happened in France, they had cut down the working hours, but then they were believed that they were no longer competitive, so they had to go back to increasing the working hours and thereby increase the probability of increasing the value of S. So that, in a nutshell, is what, according to Marx, is the issue with capitalism. And as you can see, it has very little to do with communism, so to say. Marx did talk about communism, but not perhaps in his book, Das Kapital, only 3% or 2% of the entire book was dedicated towards communism. 97-98% deals with asking very rational questions, which I believe every company today in the capitalistic free market economy is asking. So is Marx relevant, or has he been kind of discredited and proved to be wrong? I think the verdict is out there. We don't know. I mean, there is a research in the interest in Marx and his theories, and like you can see, it's very much math, so to say. The classical economics of Adam Smith doesn't hold in today's day and age, in the market economy that we are seeing, this post-capitalistic world that we are seeing. So the baker and the and then the candlestick maker and the butcher are no longer, so to say, operating in so-called free market economy. The Amazons of the world, the Facebooks of the world, the Googles of the world are beyond even government regulations and government rules and regulations. They don't need government intervention, so as to say, which was one of the fundamental keystones of Keynesian economics. So it is a new world that we are living in, and whether Marx is relevant or not, only time will say. But capitalism as we knew it certainly is dead. We are now in a world of post-capitalism, or meta-capitalism, if you will. Thank you.